Hello video creators, welcome to Storysium. In today's tutorial I will show you how to give your modern digital footage an old school vintage look like this. We can do this all inside Adobe Premiere Pro without the need for any paid plugins or presets. Instead we'll just use some built-in effects and free overlays. We're going to start here inside Premiere with this clip from the lady riding the bike. Here inside the project panel I've got three overlay videos, two of them I found on pixabay.com and the other one is from videvo.net. I will add some links in the description so you can download them as well. Now I'm going to start here by dragging the first overlay, the damaged video, over to the timeline and place this on top of the clip. As you can see, this overlay has a 1080p resolution and I'm working in a 4K sequence. So that's why I'm going to right click on the overlay video and then select set to frame size. This will scale the video to the size or the resolution of the sequence. In the next step we're going to change the blend mode because we only want to see the white part of this video, the scratches and the dust. And to achieve this we need to set blend mode to screen. And then as you can see here on the timeline, this overlay video is not long enough to cover the entire video clip. But luckily this one is loopable, which means that we can make a copy and then place this after the other one. Now we can add the next overlay video, which is the film burns video from videvo.net. I will add this one on the third track on top of the other two. And this one has a 720p resolution, so we need to scale it up. And we also need to change the blend mode here, so we're going to change this one into screen. These film burns look pretty realistic to me, but there are also some long bright parts that I don't like that much. So I'm going to cut these parts out, so only the short flashes will remain. I will switch to the razor tool by hitting the C key and then cut the track. After that I go back to the selection tool by hitting the V key and then hit the delete key to remove the part. And now as you can see only the bright flashes remain and that's exactly what I want. We can also shorten this overlay video because it's a little too long in this case. And now we can add the next overlay, which is a Super 8 projector showing an empty film. And this overlay is also long enough, so we can also shorten this one and also delete the audio track because we don't need it. And because this one is also 1080p, I need to scale it up by selecting set to frame size. With this overlay, we only want to see what's behind the white or lighter parts, so that's why I'm going to select blend mode darken. And so far, by adding three overlay videos and changing the blend mode, we've added this look to our video. In the next step we're going to start by playing around with the colors. If I select the video clip and then go to the Lumetri Scopes panel, you can see that this clip will cover the entire IRE scale from 0 to 100. And by the way, if you can't find this Lumetri Scopes panel, you can activate this here inside the window menu on top. And then here to the right on the timeline I've added a couple of screenshots from some random Super 8 footage that I found on YouTube. And I'm going to use these as a reference for our clip. So if I select the Super 8 footage, you can see that the values are somewhere between 20 and 70 IRE. Some of the shadows are crushed and you won't see any deep black, and most of the colors are washed out. And besides that, I also noticed a bit of a green tint in the screenshots. So I'm going to take this all into account and then start tweaking our own footage to make this look like the Super 8 footage. I'll start by lowering the contrast, then the shadows, and also the whites. As you can see, this pushes the highlights back to somewhere around 70 IRE. And then by increasing the blacks you will get a bit of a washed out effect in the darker parts of the image. Let's also increase the highlights a little bit because it might get too dark. And then the last one is lowering the saturation. Keep in mind that the values that I use work on this footage. You might need something else for your clips. I can recommend you to search on YouTube for some Super 8 footage and use this as an example for your own videos. Next there's one more thing that I want to do inside the Lumetri color panel, and that is adding the green tint that I mentioned before. And to do this we need to go to the color wheel step. And in here I'm going to add a subtle increase of green to the midtones color wheel. Okay, that looks great. I think that's enough color grading for now. Let's continue with the next effect. I'm going to move over to the effects panel and I'm going to search for the noise effect. And in this case we want to use the noise effect with hardware acceleration in the noise and grain folder. Let's apply this effect to the bottom video clip and then move over to the effect controls panel. And in there I'm going to increase the noise amount to 20. It's kinda hard to see this way, but if I zoom in the program monitor you will see the noise that is added, especially if I turn the effect on and off. But still, the picture is way too sharp for a Super 8 video, so that's why we're going to add a bit of blur, in this case Gaussian blur. I will add this one to the bottom video as well, and then inside the effect controls panel I'm going to increase blurriness to 5. And this already starts to look a lot more like a Super 8 film. Let's zoom out again, and then we're going to add the next effect, which is the offset effect. Let's add this one to the video track, and then inside the effect controls panel enable keyframes for shift center. Let's move a couple of frames forward and then change the position, and this will create a second keyframe. Then again move a couple of frames forward and then click this icon to reset the values, and this will create the third keyframe. And with these couple of keyframes we've now created a small offset glitch. And of course you can add multiple of these glitches, but in this case we're going to add one more. So I'll move the playhead here, then create the first keyframe, move a few frames forward and then change the position, and then add the final keyframe by resetting the value. Okay, perfect, let's do a quick playback to see what we've got so far. The next effect that I'm going to add will help us to mimic the frame rate of a Super 8 film. In the effects panel I'm going to search for the Posterize time effect. Let's apply this effect to the bottom video layer, and then inside the effect controls panel you can see that this video has a 24 frames per second frame rate. A quick search on Google told me that the frame rate for a Super 8 video is 18 frames per second. So let's use that, we're going to change 24 fps into 18 fps. This posterized time effect might need some rendering before you can get some proper playback on the timeline, as you can see by this red line here. And to do this, click somewhere on the timeline and then hit the Enter key to start the rendering. And then if the rendering is done, it's time to have a look at the final results of this tutorial. And that's it for this Premiere Pro tutorial. I hope you enjoyed it, and if you did, then please like the video, that really helps me to grow my channel. And speaking about growing my channel, don't forget to visit and subscribe to my second channel, I would really appreciate that. And that's it for this one, thanks a lot for watching, and I hope you have a wonderful day.